हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सो टेस्ट 72 का डिस्कशन स्टार्ट करते हैं। ओवरऑल पेपर इजी साइड पर है, 26 क्वेश्चंस इजी हैं, 15 अराउंड क्वेश्चंस मॉडरेटली डिफिकल्ट है एंड 4 क्वेश्चंस को मैंने डिफिकल्ट की कैटेगरी में रखा है। सो 150 to 155, 160 इज अ गुड स्कोर। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट फ्रॉम क्वेश्चन 1। द नंबर ऑफ रिवोल्यूशंस डन बाय एन इलेक्ट्रॉन इन 1 second in the first orbit of a hydrogen atom. So frequency puchhiye humse ground state mein. So frequency we know is speed upon 2 pi r. Now in ground state speed is 2.18 into 10 to the power 6 meters per second. And radius of Bohr orbit in ground state is 0.53 angstrom. So 0.53 into 10 to the power minus 10. Okay. So 0.53 into 2, 1.06 into 2. So roughly it is 2. So 2 upon 3.14, that is 20 upon 3.14 into 10 to the power 15. So 6 point something into 10 to the power 15. So A is correct option. Next, given a sample of 226 having a half-life of this, find the probability a nucleus disintegrates after 2 half-lives. So after 2 half-lives. So number of nuclei undecayed after 2 half-lives upon total number of nuclei initial. Okay, number of nuclei initially, that is probability. So number of nuclei decayed after 2 half-lives, so remaining number of nuclei is n0 by 4 and upon total number of nuclei n0, so probability should be 1 by 4. So according to me the probability should be 1 by 4. A ball of mass m moving at a speed v makes a head on. The kinetics of the balls after the collision 3/4 of the original. So loss is m1 m2 upon m1 plus m2 v relative ka whole square 1 minus e square. So final kinetic energy is 3/4 of the initial. That means loss is 1/4 of the initial. So 1/4 is half mu square. M1 m2 upon m1 plus m2. So this is m by 4 into u square into 1 minus e square. So 1 minus e square is 1 by 2 or e is 1 by root 2. So B is the correct option. Spaceship traveling in the interstellar medium is picking up dust. So interstellar medium, that means no external force is acting. It is far away from Earth and alpha is positive constant. It is picking up dust. So say spaceship has velocity v. So if spaceship has velocity v, then the relative velocity of dust picked is minus v, because dust particles are at rest and spaceship is moving with speed v. So relative to spaceship, the speed of the dust particle picked is minus v. Velocity of dust particles picked is minus v. Now we have variable mass equation. M dv by dt is equal to f plus v relative dm by dt. Now no external force is acting, so dv by dt, that is acceleration, is v relative, which is minus v, dm by dt, that is alpha v, and upon m. So minus alpha v square upon m, this is the answer. The ball rotated on horizontal, maximum tension, ball rotated on a horizontal circular path. Horizontal circular path, that means it is a conical pendulum. So it is a conical pendulum, this is rotating in this manner. Okay, so tension is at this angle is theta, this angle is also theta. So vertical component of tension is getting balanced by mg and horizontal component is providing the required cerebral force. Here radius is l sine theta. So t sine theta is equal to m omega square r, which is l sine theta. So omega max is टी मैक्स अपॉन एम एल अंडर रूट. सो टी मैक्स इज 324, एम एल इज 1/2, सो दैट इज 4 अंडर रूट. सो दिस इज 18 × 2, 36 रेडियंस पर सेकेंड. कार मूविंग ऑन अ सर्कुलर लेवल रोड, द कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ फ्रिक्शन इज दिस, एक्सेलरेशन टू द मैक्सिमम स्पीड द कार कैन हैव. सो इन द लिमिटिंग केस एफ एस मैक्स विच इज म्यू एस एम जी इज प्रोवाइडिंग द रिक्वायर्ड सेंटीमीटर फोर्स एम वी मैक्स का स्क्वेयर अपॉन आर. सो वी मैक्स इज म्यू एस आर जी अंडर रूट. नाउ म्यू एस इज 0.3, आर इज 300 एंड जी इज 10. सो 900, सो दैट इज 30 meters per second, विच इज 30 × 18/5. सो 18 × 6 = 108 किलोमीटर पर आवर. सो सी इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. ई डिनोट्स द इलेक्ट्रिकल फील्ड. सो ड्रिफ्ट स्पीड वी डी इज जे अपॉन एनी एंड जे इज सिग्मा ई अपॉन एनी. सो प्रपोर्शनल टू इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. सो वी डी इज प्रपोर्शनल टू इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. सो ए इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. एंड देन पावर इज वी स्क्वायर बाय आर एंड वी इज ई एल. सो ई स्क्वायर एल स्क्वायर अपॉन आर. सो प्रपोर्शनल टू ई स्क्वायर. सो दिस इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. पावर इज एंड देन पावर इज वी डी. सो सिंस वी डी इज प्रपोर्शनल टू ई, सो पावर इज प्रपोर्शनल टू वी डी स्क्वायर. सो दिस इज फॉल्स. एंड P is I square R, so proportional to I square. So this is correct option. So C is the correct answer. The resistance of wire is R. The wire is stretched to double its length, keeping its volume constant. Yeah, right? When volume is constant, so when length is made doubled, area will reduce to half. So R is rho L by A, which is rho L square by AL. AL is volume, so proportional to L square. So R dash by R is 4. So resistance become 4 times of its initial value. An electric motor which is loaded has an effective resistance of this, inductive reactance there, the motor is powered, the maximum current. So I max is V max upon Z, that is V max upon R square plus XL square under root. So V max is 420 and R square plus XL square under root is 50. So that is 8.4. ampere. So B is the correct option. Electric field outside the region containing magnetic field. So we know outside the region electric field induced is capital R square upon 2 small r dv by dt. So proportional to 1 upon small r. So decreases as 1 by small r. An electric dipole is placed at an angle of theta. Electric field this, experience torque this, the charge on the dipole if the dipole length is this. So torque is P, which is QLP E sine theta. So Q is torque, which is 4 newton meter upon L, which is 2 × 10⁻², electric field, which is 2 × 10⁵, and sine theta, which is half. So this is 2 × 10⁻³, that is 2 millicoulomb. So B is the correct option. Two uniformly long charge wires have densities lambda, 3 lambda, are placed along x and y axis. So this is wire lying along y axis and it has density 3 lambda, and this is wire lying along x axis and this has density lambda. Now we have a point on the line. This is point, say this has coordinates x comma y. So electric field due to wire lying along x-axis, electric field due to wire lying along x-axis is 2k lambda upon y, and electric field due to wire lying along y-axis is 2k 3 lambda upon x. This distance is x, this distance is y. So resultant electric field tan theta is Ey upon Ex, that is 2k lambda y upon 2k 3 lambda upon x. So this is x upon 3y, okay, एंड y इज गिवन रूट थ्री एक्स, सो x अपॉन 3√3x, सो थीटा इज tan इनवर्स, tan थीटा इज 1/√3, स्लोप निकालना था, सो tan थीटा इज 1/√3√3, सो C is the correct option. Time period of satellite is this. If separation between the Earth and satellite is increased to 4 times, so time period is proportional to r to the power 3/2. So if r dash is 4r, then t dash is 8 times t. So it is 40 hours. 14. The radius of the Earth is r. The height at where the acceleration of gravity becomes 1% of its initial value. 1% means g/100, the value becomes g/100. So g dash is g capital R square upon small r square. So g/100 is equal to g capital R square upon small r square. So small r is 10 times capital R. So h is 9 r. So b is the correct option. If the temperature of solvent to increase from T to 2T radius, this the ratio of radiant energy received by Earth. So radiant energy received by the Earth will be proportional to the energy emitted by the Sun, H, which is sigma into 4 pi RS square into TS to the power 4. So proportional to RS square TS to the power 4. So H dash upon H 2 square into 2 raised to power 4, that is 64. So energy will received will become 64 times of its initial value. A Carnot engine working between this and this, the amount of heat supplied to the engine. So W upon QH is 1 minus TC by TH. Okay. So W is 800. W is 800. QH is to be found out. And 1 minus TC 300 by 400, so 1/4, so QH is 3200 joule. So B is the correct option. Here it is vacuum, on the right side it is vacuum, on the left side is the gas, and the spring constant is the pressure of the gas in the final situation. So in the final situation, when the piston is displaced by X, the rightward spring gets compressed, so it exerts force KX. Leftward spring gets extended, so it again exerts force KX, and pressure force is exerted outside. So in equilibrium, PA equals twice of KX. So we have to find out pressure. So pressure is 2K, which is 100, X, which is L/2, so half, upon area, which is 1 meter square. So this is 100 Pascal, 100 Newton per meter square. Galvanometer with a scale divided into 100 equal divisions has current sensitivity of 10 divisions per milliampere. So IG, 10 divisions per milliampere. So on 100 divisions, the current read will be 10 milliampere. Similarly, voltage sensitivity, 2 divisions per millivolt. So on 2 divisions, we read 1 millivolt. So on 100 divisions, we'll read Vmax, which is IG into G, we will read 50 millivolt. Okay, so Vmax upon IG, that is G, which is 5 ohm. So resistance of galvanometer is 5 ohm. Electron disc experience no deflection to an electric field when E, B, V are mutually perpendicular. When electric field is removed, the electron will revolve in an orbit. So since E, V, B are mutually perpendicular and force is zero, so E equals BV or V equals E by B. Now radius is MV by QB, now M by EB, and speed is E by B. So mass is 9.1 into 10 to power minus 31. Electric field is 3.2 into 10 to power 5. And electronic charge is 1.6 into 10 to power minus 19. And B square is 4 into 10 to power minus 6. Okay, so 3.2. 6.4, so this is 2, and 10 to power minus 6, 10 to power minus 19, 10 to power minus 25, 10 to power 5, 10 to power 30, so this is 10 to power minus 1, so 0.91 upon 2, that is 0.45 meter, so C is the correct option. Calculate the real angle of dip if magnet is suspended at an angle of 30 degree to the magnetic meridian, okay, so this is suppose magnetic meridian. सो दिस इज BH एंड दिस इज BV एंड दिस इज करेक्ट एंगल ऑफ डिप. नाउ इन अ प्लेन विच इज एट एन एंगल ऑफ 30 डिग्री टू द मैग्नेटिक मेरिडियन. सो दिस डायरेक्शन इज 30 डिग्री. सो इन दिस प्लेन BH dash is BH cos 30 degree. So angle of dip in this plane tan theta dash is BV upon BH dash, which is BV upon BH cos 30. Now BV upon BH is true angle of dip, that is tan theta upon cos 30 degree. So the dip makes calculate the real angle of dip. So tan theta is tan theta dash into cos 30 degree. Tan theta dash is 145 degree and into root 3 by 2. So tan inverse root 3 by 2. So A is the correct option. Root 3 by 2, yes, tan inverse root 3 by 2. So A is the correct option. The x and y components are this, the acceleration of particle. So dx by dt is 7 plus 8t d2x by dt2, which is acceleration in x direction, is 8. Dy by dt is 5. D2y by dt2, which is acceleration in y direction, is 0. So net acceleration is 8 meter per second square. So B is the correct option. Large number of bullets are fired in all direction, what is the maximum possible area? So maximum possible area is pi range max square, and range max is u square by g. So u square by g whole square. So that is pi u4 upon g square. So B is the correct option. Body of mass 50 kg suspended using a spring balance. If the lift starts falling freely, so when lift starts falling freely, G effective is zero. So it is weightlessness state. So tension in the spring is zero. So reading of spring balance will be zero. The normal reaction of body placed in a lift moving up with an acceleration. So for the free body diagram, normal reaction is up, mg is down, and n minus mg is equal to ma. So normal reaction on a body is 120 mass of the body. So m is n upon g plus a, which is 120 upon 12, that is 10 kg. So a is the correct option. 1 milligram of matter when converted into energy. So if we can calculate from E equals mc square. Next, if a radioactive disintegration, the ratio of initial number of atoms to the number of atoms present at an instant of time equal to its mean life. So n is n naught e to the power minus lambda, and t is mean life, so 1 by lambda. So this is n naught by e. So n naught upon n is e. So c is the correct option. Particle of mass this attached to a spring force executes simple harmonic motion. The time period of oscillation of the particle. So time period is t is 2 pi under root m by k. We can substitute f and k and m and calculate the time period. Point mass performing SHM is given by x given by this. After the ellipse of what fraction of time period, the velocity of point will be equal to half of maximum velocity. So we know maximum velocity is omega a by 2. And we want V to be V max by 2, that is omega A by 4. Omega A, and we want V max by 2, that is omega A by 2. So V square equals omega square A square. V square is omega square A square minus X square. V square is omega square A square minus X square. So V square is omega square A square by 4 is omega square A square minus omega square X square. So X is root 3 A by 2. Now root 3 A by 2 is equal to A sine of omega T plus pi by 6. So omega T plus pi by 6 is equal to pi by 3. That is 2 pi by capital T into small t is equal to pi by 6. So T is capital T by 12. Or other way around, we could have calculated first velocity, which is dx by dt. सो दैट इज ओमेगा ए, ओमेगा ए कॉस ऑफ ओमेगा टी प्लस पाई बाई सिक्स एंड इक्वेटेड टू हाफ ऑफ मैक्सिमम वेलोसिटी दैट इज ओमेगा ए बाई टू. सो कॉस ओमेगा टी प्लस पाई बाई सिक्स इज हाफ, सो ओमेगा टी प्लस पाई बाई सिक्स इज इक्वल टू पाई बाई थ्री एंड देन वी कुड हैव सॉल्व फॉर स्मॉल टी बाई कैपिटल टी. Huygens wave theory of light gives us wave theory, so it cannot explain photoelectric effect, that can be explained only on based on particle nature of the light. At its closest approach, the separation between mass and earth is this, and then the signal send a radio message from a space probe of the mass to the earth, time taken. So t will be distance upon speed, so 60 million kilometers, 60 into 10 to the power 6 kilometer, 10 to the power 3 and upon 3 into 10 to power 8, so that is 200 seconds. So B is the correct option. Block of wood floats in fresh water with 2/3 of its volume submerged. So for floating body, mg equals buoyancy force. So mg equals 2/3 of volume, 2v by 3 rho w g. And same body when submerged in an unknown liquid, it floats with 1/4 of its volume submerged. So buoyancy force is v by 4 rho into g. So rho is 8 by 3 rho w, that is 8 by 3 into 1000 kilogram per meter cube, to 2666.7. this is the correct option. The velocities of points a and b, so va upon vb is ab upon aa, that is rb square upon ra square, so that is 4:1. So velocity at a is 4 times velocity at b. An astronomical telescope has an angular magnification of 5. So angular magnification is given 5. Okay. And the tube length, separation between objective and eyepiece, that is given us how much? 36 centimeter. So angular magnification M is minus 5. That is minus FO by FE. So we get one equation, FO equals 5 times FE. And second, FO plus FE, which is tube length, is 36 centimeter. So this is second equation. Solving these two equations, we can calculate FO and FE. Compound microscope has magnifying power. So magnifying power MP is MO, M objective into M eyepiece. Okay. So magnifying power is given minus 35. MO is to be found out, or an ME is 1 plus D by FE. So minus 35 is equal to MO 1 plus 25 upon 10. So this is MO comes out to be minus 10. When a ceiling fan is switched off, its angular velocity falls to omega half while it makes 36 revolutions. So using the equation omega square barabar omega naught square minus 2 alpha delta theta. So omega naught square by 4 is equal to omega naught square minus 2 alpha delta theta 1. So here delta theta 1 is 3 by 4 omega naught square upon 2 alpha, and similarly 0 equals omega naught square by 4 minus 2 alpha delta theta 2. So delta theta 2 is 1 by 4 omega naught square upon 2 alpha. So delta theta 2 is delta theta 1 by 3. Okay, so 36 by 3, so 12 revolutions. Body is lying in YZ plane. So according to perpendicular axis theorem, IX should be equal to IY plus IZ. IX should be equal to IY plus IZ. With forward bias mode, the PN junction width of depletion layer decreases, potential barrier decreases, and since current flows, so it acts as a closed switch. So C is the correct option. Transistor is used in as an amplifier in common base mode. So AV is alpha into R load upon R input. So alpha is given 0.98. R load is 70 into 10 to the power 3. And load, 5. The input resistance is 70 kilo ohm. Okay. So just a minute. So R load is 5 kilo ohm, 5 into 10 to the power 3, and R input, it should have been only 70 ohm, okay, and the input resistance is less than the load resistance, so here it is misprinted, kilo ohm, it should have been 70 ohm, otherwise answer won't come. So I have taken 70, so this comes out to be 514, and this is 14 into 0.07, so this is 70. So A is the correct option if we consider the input resistance to be 70 ohm, otherwise it will be bonus. The total kinetic energy of mixture of 4 gram of hydrogen atom, so number of moles of hydrogen N1 is 4 upon 2, that is 2 moles, and number of moles is of helium, that is 4 upon 4 over 1. So now total kinetic energy, so hydrogen is diatomic, so kinetic energy is total kinetic energy of gas is NCVT, so that is N1 5R by 2 into T plus N2, helium is monoatomic, 3R by 2 into T. This is total kinetic energy, so this is 2 into 5R by 2 into T, which is 300, plus 1 into 3R by 2 into T, which is 300. Okay, so this is 300 by 2, 150 common, and this is 10 plus 3, 13R. So this comes out to be 13 fives are 1950R. So C is the correct option. The SI unit of specific heat, so this is per unit mass, so joule per kg per Kelvin. So D is the correct option. In YDIC, the fringe width is found to be this. If the whole apparatus is, so fringe width is W is lambda capital D upon small d is proportional to lambda. So W dash upon W is lambda dash upon lambda. Lambda dash is lambda by N. So this is 1 by N. So W dash is W by N. W is 0.4 mm and N is 4 by 3. So this is 0.3 mm. Next, in a double slit experiment, the distance between slits is increased 10 times, whereas their distance from the screen is half the fringe width. So W is lambda D by D is proportional to capital D by D. So W dash upon W, capital D is half and small d is made 10 times, so 1 by 20, so becomes 1/20th of initial value. If the end correction of an open pipe, so if end correction at one end is small e, which is 0. End correction small e is 0.6 times radius. Now since it is open pipe, so end correction is on both sides, so total end correction is 1.2 r, that is equal to 0.8 centimeter. So r is 0.8 upon 1.2, that is 2 by 3 centimeter. So 2 by 3 centimeter is the correct option. Transverse wave, the speed of wave pulse at a distance x from the free end. So this is a string, and at a distance x from free end, first we need to calculate tension. So the force acting on the lower x length is, suppose, tension force F. So F is mass of this portion, which is m by l into x into g. Now speed is f by mu under root, so that is mgx by l, and mu is m by l, so this is under root gx, so proportional to under root x. So C is the correct option. Particle moves this velocity force instantaneous power. So instantaneous power is f vector dot v vector, which is fx vx plus fy vy plus fz vz. So fx vx 50, fy vy 30, and fz vz 120. So this is 200 watt. So C is the correct option. So that's all for today. Jo bhi naye concepts hai unko achhi tarah seekh